النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the hadith, a woman may be married for four qualities or one of four qualities, the beauty, the wealth, the family lineage, and the religious commitment. And he said, فَظْفَرْ بِذَاتِ الدِّينِ تَرِبَتْ يَدَاكَ. I know that, mashallah, women are very beautiful there and everything, but what really counts as the most important is the religious commitment. The woman who would help you to get up to pray Fajr, the woman who would teach your children the importance of loving the Prophet and the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the mothers of the believers. Ya Safi, imagine if you happen to marry a woman who would teach her children, no, Aisha is not our mother. And Abu Bakr was not a good guy. She's belying the Quran. She's denouncing the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You liked her. Can you imagine that your wife, the mother of your children, would be teaching your children so? And you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Ahzab, النَّبِيُّ أَوْلَى بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ مِنْ أَنفُسِهِمْ وَأَزْوَاجُهُ أُمَّهَاتُهُمْ. The wives of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, all of them are the mothers of the believers. So you know when somebody says, oh no, she's not my mother. I have an issue with Aisha and I have an issue with Abu Bakr. How could I marry this woman? Tell me how. Just tell me. A woman whom the Prophet ﷺ loved the most, as I will tell you the hadith. And Abu Bakr, a man whom the Prophet ﷺ loved the most. Then somebody who happened to be my wife. She's teaching my children not to like Abu Bakr, not to like Umar, rather to curse them and to curse Aisha radiallahu anha, whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed ayat in her innocence and righteousness in the Quran. It means this woman would be denying the Quran. What kind of wife, what kind of mother would she be? Amr ibn al-As, may Allah be pleased with him, said, once I asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulallah, whom do you love most? He said, Aisha radiallahu anha. He said, I didn't mean of women, I meant of men. Whom do you love most? He said, her father, Abu Bakr. May Allah be pleased with him. He said, then whom? He said, Umar, then whom? Then Uthman, then Ali, and so on. The hadith. Somebody whom the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam loved most. How could I marry a woman, or if the woman is a Sunni woman, would marry a man who would say, I don't like Abu Bakr, I don't like Umar, I don't like Aisha, she is not my mother. You're right, she is not your mother, because you're not one of the believers. Allah says, the wives of the Prophet ﷺ are the mothers of the believers. They do not realize that simply by rejecting an ayah, rejecting a hukm that has been revealed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they don't count from amongst those whom Allah addresses in the ayah. وَأَزْوَاجُهُ أُمَّهَاتُهُمْ. So, mashallah, there are plenty of Muslim righteous Sunni women. Choose a woman whom the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam advised you to be the mother of your children. You would say, yeah, she is willing to convert and so on, and she would not curse any of the companions, etc. What about the uncles? Your kids are going to call whom an uncle? Think about it. Barakallahu feek.